Earlier, we saw that screen readers will announce an element's role, name, state, and value, not necessarily in that order. By using the right semantic element, we've got role, state, and value covered, but we also need to make sure that we're making an element's name discoverable. This is actually the very first item on WebAIM's checklist: provide text alternatives for any non-text content. At this point, I'm going to take a quick tangent on terminology. We're in the unfortunate position of having all of these terms, each of which is overloaded in its own particular way in HTML, which are all also used in various contexts to refer to the same central concept we're talking about in this lesson. Since the way the term label is used in HTML is closest to what we mean here, for the rest of this course, I'm going to refer to label interchangeably to refer to this concept. But please keep in mind that in the context of role, name, value, and state, the name means the same thing. With that out of the way, let's talk a bit about labels. Broadly, there are two types of labels. Visible labels, which are used by all users to associate meaning with an element, and text alternatives, which are only used when there's no need for a visual label. So here we've got an image that is self-explanatory to anyone who can see the image. By its very nature, a text alternative is usually not visible on the page. So in this case, we can see this image of bee swarming. An assistive technology user would simply have access to this bee swarming label. The checklist provides a list of recommendations for how to create visible and non-visible labels. The easiest is this one. Form buttons have a descriptive value. A button typically has some text content, and that acts as the button's text alternative. Since this text is visible to both sighted users and assistive technology, we're lucky because we don't need to do any more work to create a good experience for assistive technology users. So that's an easy one to check off. Next, we need to check that form inputs have associated text labels. When we create a form input like a checkbox and just put some text next to it, we get a visual label, but we don't actually create a programmatically accessible label for the element we're trying to label. Also, we don't get the nice behavior where we can click on the label to toggle the checkbox. We can fix this by using a label element. We can either wrap the input element like this, or we can use the for attribute on the label. If we do that, we need to make sure to give the input element an ID and use the same ID as the value of the for attribute. That creates an association between the label element and the input element. Whichever of these two methods we use, we will get an accessible label for the checkbox, and we'll be able to toggle the checkbox by clicking the label.